today. I'm going to do a little wiring. Need to up lengthen the wires on the hot side for the battery. I already did the ground side, so that's not going to be in this video. It's a 6-gauge cable. Working on just the starter and alternator wire right now. Need to go get connectors. Well, darn. Alright. We'll be back in a few minutes, guys. I need to go get a connector. Alright, I'm back, everybody. So I gotta wait for the 6-gauge cable because I have to wait for the connectors to come in. I'm going to strip this one back a little further. And then what I'll do is I'll set the video back up to do this cable. I'll just do the rest of the cables right now. I'll do the rest of the cables right now instead. Husky sockets and gear wrench. Ratchet. And off my light wires for my HIDs. This is 2-gauge wire for the main. Wire is actually looking pretty good. Thank you. nice and tight. Grab this one. Knife. And they don't have to be perfect. You know, they don't have to be perfectly cut or anything else. As long as the crimps are good, you should be fine. Just spreading the copper a little bit. Done. All right. Pause it. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. So, nice tight connection. But See if this will fit over. All right, so that heat shrink fits over. Okay. Spun. Accidentally loosened it. Copper lug's crimped. It's got a nice secure connection. Some heat shrink. Cable's done. I just need to heat shrink it. The reason I'm doing this is I'm getting rid of this crappy connector because my coolant bottle sits right here and it's like extremely close. So I'm trying to make it a little longer because in order to get the battery out, you can only lift this like a couple inches and it's not enough room because I put a bigger battery in it. So I'm just going to get rid of this connector and I'm going to add this style connector, which this is made by Ill Customs. This is for audio, but you can use it as a crank for cranking batteries. It's not a big deal. It's made of 6061 electrical aluminum. So see how it works out after I install everything. I'll give a review on the four post connector after I've had it on the truck for long enough to see how well it works. Okay. until I feel it, the blade actually touch the copper, and then I know I went all the way through. It's not a hard job. It's just time consuming. And this is on a 2005 Ford Excursion with a 6.8 liter V10. Anybody's wondering? Make this a little shorter. Just a little bit. That's a little better. Okay. Being a pain. This is a hydraulic crimping tool. It's made by Temco. It's a really good tool. Works really well. Both of these cables I made the exact same length, so. Done. Hopefully you guys can see. Sorry if my arm's in the way. One's done. Nice secure connection. I'm gonna come back after a short break. All right, I'm back. Okay, so I got my TacLife heat gun, so I can do that. And then I need to finish this one right real quick. Put the copper lug on it. Nice. Connection. Unless it blew away. A little breezy out here, so it might not be working as well, but I don't want to turn the heat gun up, so that one's done. I only have the heat gun at 700 degrees, so and this heat shrink has glue inside it, so it melts the glue and adheres it to it, so it's a nice strong waterproof connection. I don't know if you can see the glue coming out. It's all good. All right. So that's done. Okay. Forgot the bolt I put in here. Since I extended them, so I'm just gonna basically just test them real quick. Make sure that they fit on the connector. Ground side. This is the ground side. So this cable and the thick cable, which goes to this right here. It runs down this way and it actually bolts to the frame. So all the wiring's done. I just gotta put the battery back in. The only other thing I gotta do is this one right here for the starter and the alternator, which I will come back and do that as soon as I get the connectors. They're on order. They'll be here, you know, in probably, what is it? They'll be here about 4 hours. So I'll see you guys then. Thanks for watching, and I will continue this when I get the connectors. All right, so this will be the last wire for the lengthening. Good. All right. Oh, I need to strip. Oh, I already stripped this one. Loving this hydraulic crimp tool. Works really good. Okay. Nice secure connection. And then I gotta redo these for my lights. But, you know, I'm not gonna do that on camera. It's like 20 seconds worth of crimping. Shrink will fit. Nope, not gonna fit. Yeah, that fits.
Right there.
Okay. Hopefully this video comes out okay for you guys. Got wings, but you know, it'll work. As long as it works, it don't matter. That's all done. So make sure it connects to the post. Yep, it will connect perfectly fine. Like all three wires. I will reroute them when I'm about ready to hook it up. This was just to make sure everything connected and I got everything I needed. Please like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell notification icon if you like these videos so you don't miss any new videos, and I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching.